Howdy, this is Warner Stepper from Fiasco Sports, reporting on behalf of the SA Footballer magazine to bring you this week's Division 2 Weekly Roundup. This week, Walkerville Football Director Liam Caroll is joining me. Thanks for coming on, mate.
Thanks, mate. Nice to be here.
Cheers. All right, to get things started, we're going to take a look at last weekend's Round 10 winners and losers. First up, there was a bit of a shock result with the draw between ladder leader Unley Mercedes Jets and St. Peter's Old Collegians. Gazers showed that they're still a threat, crushing Jepps Cross by 97 points. Broadview also delivered, beating out the upper table Modbury by 34 points. Scotch Old Collegians got over Smosh Westlakes by 19 points. And finally, there was your game, and unfortunately, in bad news for Walkerville, you fell to Prince Alfred Old Collegians by a whopping 96 points. Well, it's been a tough season, obviously not the desired result again, mate, but how did the game actually unfold? Any positives from your boys?
We're actually in it for three quarters, really. I think about halfway through the third quarter, it was about 9-7, and then unfortunately we fell away quite badly after that. They kicked, I think, the last 13 goals of the game.
Tough one from those boys there, I see. But in every game, there's always players that stand up. Who are the best performers for you guys on a tough weekend?
Stuart Callery's at the age of about 34. He's having a really good season through the midfield. Other than that, I think up forward, young Hugo Wallace is having a good season, just his second year in amateur football. But other than that, it was a pretty tough day at the office.
Good work from those boys in pretty trying conditions. All right, what about any other games around? Did any results stick out to you? What about that draw? You know, it's not that common to have draws in this league.
No, both those sides, Gazer and Unley, are very, very good sides. So, we think that they'll probably go deep into the final series. So, yeah, there's a few quality sides in Div 2, and they're definitely two of the best.
All right, now we'll move on to the upcoming games. I'm going to grab Liam's tips for the next round. All right, Liam, who wins between Broadview and Smosh Westlakes?
I'd say Broadview would be probably too strong for Smosh, but, both pretty good sides.
What sort of scoreline?
Probably 4 goals to Broadview, I'd say, if I had to guess.
What about Jepps Cross versus St. Peter's?
I think St. Peter's have been playing pretty good football of late. I think they'll be too strong for Jepps. Probably, probably upwards of 10 goals, I expect.
Could expect a big win there for St. Peter's. Who's going to get up in the exciting top four clash between Unley Mercedes Jets and Prince Alfred Old Collegians?
Maybe just Unley by 1 to 2 goals. Both sides, I think, again, very, very good sides. I think they'll both be thereabouts at the end of the season.
Good encounter there, if you can watch that one. Can you pick a winner between Scotch and Gazer? Gazer coming off another big win. You know, they're around the top of the table.
Yeah, I think they're about as good as we've seen. I think Gazer will probably be too strong for Scotch on the form lines we've been looking at.
How many points do you reckon?
Probably four or five goals. So, yeah, 24 to 30 points.
All right, then there's your game. Reckon you can get a win against Walkerville? Against Modbury. Sorry, guys are Walkerville, obviously.
Yeah. Look, Modbury are right up the top of the ladder, so thereabouts. I think we're back at home, so always a chance. But, we'll be definitely, it'll be a turn up if we do have a win. But
how many do you reckon you'd be happy with?
We'll take a 1-point victory, to be honest. Anything, we'll take anything at the moment. But
a win's a win. It's always good there. We'll talk about last time you met him. So unfortunately, Modbury were able to smash you earlier in the year. That was their home game, though. Mm. So what adjustments will the boys need to make if they're going to have the best chance of winning this time around?
That was, I think, early on in the season. It was probably still a slightly new group, still gelling. I think we've been a lot more competitive than some of our early season form. So I think if we can stay in the game as long as possible and have a real defensive mindset, it'll hold us in good stead. Just got to stay with them as long as possible and see if we can have an upset.
Good high work rate from them boys. We'll give them the best chance there. Just to finish, there's still plenty of season left, which means there's a lot of time to improve. You guys aren't off to the best start. So what sort of improvements do you want from the boys by the end of the season?
Our coach, Gary Cock, is, really focusing on trying to make us as competitive as possible. So and trying to stay in games for as long as possible. You know, this weekend just gone. We were really in it for three quarters and then had to run a really disappointing quarter of football in the last. So if we can have four quarters of football and it's, tough competitive football, then, I think we'll get some more results go our way in the second half of the season.
It's always good to see that sustained work rate. It's always the best way to get wins on the board and genuine improvement. All right, well, there you have it. That's this week's Division 2 Weekly Roundup with special help from Walkerville Football Director, Liam Caroll.